In this next episode, I'm going to talk about the applications of directed energy deposition and a variation with fiber reinforced composites. You might already have an idea, but direct energy deposition is really one of the processes that allows us to create the biggest parts possible. And I show you that on this slide, where you see at the bottom middle, you see a person next to the part that's being built. So I pointed out already, it's widely used for repairs and reconditioning of existing parts that have a crack. It's now used for aircraft frames and structures. It's used in marine propulsion and for refractory metal components. And what I want to point out here is a little bit more on the structure. You see, this down here is a process that works with wire. You see the scale of it, pointing out the person next to it. You see that two wires are actually fed in this case. And you see, you can really see the stair step structure. It looks very coarse. Once it's being printed, you need the machining afterwards. And on the top right, on right in general, you see another process. You see how the powder is being deposited, and you see the lines, the stair steps, but you can also see kind of the powdery structure that we get when we're working with a powder and selectively melting it. And here you see an example of a repair where two powder streams are connected here and form this new geometry. And then a variation of it is that process can be used with fiber reinforced composites called composite DED. The schematic for the process you see on the top right, you have an incoming filament. That's a continuous carbon fiber with a thermoplastic polymer that in DED would be called the wire. We call it filament here. And we have a laser heat source to melt the polymer matrix from the incoming filament or wire and also from the already deposited material. And there is a compaction roller that actually helps adhere the wire to the previously deposited layers. Here is a photo of the printhead, how it looks, with here the roller and the laser, and two examples of parts that can be produced. And similar to the metal DED that I just mentioned, we talk about structural and big scale parts. So even seeing here a bike frame, and that's really what has a big effect by directed energy deposition, even so we don't hear that much about it, is really a process to look out for, because the sheer scale of the parts we can produce is very interesting for a lot of applications. Again, for the material science, the welding is important, how the material flows and how the thermal conductivity of the material interaction with the heat source really affects the melting. And therefore the welding, which has an effect on your mechanical properties, the durability of the parts.